Now we are going to study the velocity of a particle during projectile motion. Say if a particle is thrown with the initial velocity u, which is at an angle alpha with the horizontal, it follows the projectile trajectory. If the particle was started at t equal to 0, we can state its x direction component was u cos alpha and its y direction component was u sin alpha in the beginning. So this velocity vector we can also write. We write initial velocity vector. It can be written as u vector is equals to u cos alpha I cap plus u sin alpha j cap. Now, its x direction velocity remains constant. So, this I cap component or the x component remains constant always. The y component is retarded by the acceleration g. So, it first decreases and at the topmost point, Vy becomes 0 and then it comes down and then it starts increasing again. So at any time t, if we talk about the particle, say it is moving with a velocity v vector and is making an angle theta with the x direction. So at this time its velocity in x direction would be v cos theta and in y direction it would be v sin theta. Now, this v cos theta and v sin theta, the velocity components in x and y directions can be very easily calculated. Like if we talk about along x direction, we can simply state as the particle's motion remains uniform. So, we can write v cos theta always it is equals to u cos alpha. Horizontal component never changes. So, this is our equation 1. If we talk about along motion along y direction, we can state in y direction the particle was retarded by g. So, after time t, if we are analyzing the velocity component, we can simply use v equals to u plus a t or we can write this v sin theta is equals to u sin alpha minus g t. That is our equation number 2. Here I am simply using vy is equals to u y minus g t. That is the first speed equation I am using because it is retarded uniformly by g. Now from this 1 and 2 we can simply write velocity after time t of projectile. This v vector can be written as u cos alpha I cap plus u sin alpha minus gt j cap. This is the relation we use for velocity of projectile after time t. Using this, you can easily calculate the magnitude as well as the direction in which the particle is moving.